This week, NASA held a live event to reveal its latest findings about Enceladus, one of Saturn's moons. Scientists announced that the Cassini space probe has detected hydrogen gas coming from cracks in the icy crust, indicating that the moon's subsurface oceans might be able to, dramatic pause, support life as we know it. Finding hydrogen is a big deal because it's a chemical we think is essential for life to form, the others being carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur. We have now detected all of those on Enceladus except phosphorus and sulfur, but we suspect those elements are present in its rocky core as well. To detect the hydrogen, Cassini passed through a plume of mostly water vapor coming out of the cracks, or tiger stripes, in Enceladus's crust. Enceladus is too small to keep hydrogen in its atmosphere, so the hydrogen must have come from the ocean inside the crust. The plumes of vapor spring up above hotspots, indicating hydrothermal activity exists on Enceladus's seafloor. Again, this is kind of a big deal because of what we know about our own planet. Hydrothermal activity occurs on Earth when water vapor seeps into the seafloor and is heated by magma. The heated and mineral-rich water then bursts back through the seafloor, and amazingly, ecosystems tend to spring up around it. Instead of using the sun's light to sustain them, the organisms around the vents rely on heat and chemicals for their energy. NASA's scientists speculated that something similar could be going on around Enceladus's hydrothermal vents. Using a process called methanogenesis, potential life forms could combine the hydrogen we now know is on Enceladus with carbon dioxide to produce energy, with methane as a byproduct. Methanogenesis is at the root of our tree of life and may have even been critical for life on Earth to start. One NASA scientist was quick to point out, though, that Enceladus might be too young to have given life enough time to form. It could be the conditions are right, but nobody's home yet. If there is life down there, Cassini won't be going to find out, partly because it was never equipped to detect life in the first place. Frankly, NASA didn't expect to find so many indicators that Enceladus could support it. The plan is to intentionally crush and vaporize Cassini using Saturn's atmosphere to ensure it doesn't crash into Enceladus or Titan and contaminate any life forms that might be living there. Cassini's grand finale is scheduled for September of this year, 1 month shy of 20 years in space. NASA's next mission to an ice world will be the Europa Clipper in the 2020s. The Clipper mission will study Jupiter's moon Europa, another ice world with plumes of vapor rising above it. At over 4 billion years old, Europa is much older than Enceladus, and some at NASA believe that extra time makes it a more likely candidate for supporting life. We're just gonna have to go there to find out. So let's say we find life on one of these moons, then what do you think happens next? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe while you're down there if you haven't already. If you'd like to learn more about the sea life on our ocean floor and what it could tell us to look for on Europa, check out Trace's video right here. One more thing, we got nominated for a Webby Award for sending a VR camera to the edge of space, and you can help us win. Just go to vote.webbyawards.com and search for Seeker, click vote, simple as that, or follow the link down below. And if you haven't seen it, check out the actual video on Seeker VR.